Hey, Sashan, what is going on? A few weeks ago, Grim Jim did a RPG review on this game here. It's called Any World. It's a generic roleplay system. And I'm always looking for generic roleplay systems to see if there's any diamonds in the rough. Grimm's review is just meh. He complains a lot about no indexes in the game. I don't care about indexes. I could care less if a role-play game has an index or not in it. He liked the art, and that's about it. I was curious, what's the rule? What's the game mechanic like? So, went to the source. The guy who did the game, what is it? It's, Netherborn Games. So there's a little blurb, there's a little Kickstarter thing talking about it. So this is a generic tabletop game. So it says it works with any genre. What was that? What? Emphasizing speed, flexibility, and cinematic play. Okay. If you're going to emphasize speed, there better be some speed in the game. The generic games are hard enough to do, and then you want to add speed to it. Because you're trying to cover pretty much every genre. So there could be a lot of looking up in the core book for the particular skill, for the particular genre that you're doing. Anyway, I don't know. I don't know about the speed thing. Look at GURPS. You cannot speed through GURPS. There is no GURPS speed play. There's nothing like that in existence. GURPS is the generally useless role-playing system because of that. Giving you the tools to create any world you can imagine. Okay. Spoiler alert, I'm getting really close to just having a diceless system. If you're playing a generic genre, do you really need to roll dice? Really, to do or not do the thing? Because when you roll dice, it's only for either spectator purposes or some point of interest. Roadside attraction has occurred, so you stop and look. You rubberneck. You roll the dice when that happens. See if you pull over or not. See if the attraction is a trick. It's a trap. Guys with pig heads shoved over their real heads, and they're chasing after you with flamethrowers, You would need to roll dice for something like when something like that happens. Okay. So this was the Kickstarter video. This is how most Kickstarter videos go. Lots of things to peruse here. So you got fantasy, apocalyptic. Does she look apocalyptic to you? Rosie the Riveter with the kind of hint to Pip-Boy going on here. Science fiction. What is this? Is this the guy from Young Sherlock Holmes or something? That stained glass window thing that comes alive and tries to murder people? Superheroes. Okay. Some people say there's no way you can role-play a superhero's game, but yet there's so many superhero games out there. But you talk to anybody and they say, that game sucked. That game... Everyone's review of a superhero role-playing game is, it doesn't do supers very well. And then they'll suggest a game that does supers better, and then you take a look at that game, and everyone says, oh, it doesn't do supers very well. Most of the time, you got chuckleheads playing super games, and they don't know what a superhero is. That's the big problem. That's the real issue with the gamer. They don't know what a superhero is. They barely know what an elf looks like, or what a ranger looks like, or what a thief looks like. They barely know these things. How are they going to know what a superhero is? Or something else entirely. Okay. Anyway, I'll put a link to the description, you know, in the description to this game. You know, it's on, I want to say it's on Drive-Thru. If you guys are interested in a generic thing, I was interested in this until I looked at the die mechanic. Very first thing I look at when I discover an RPG is, how do the dice work in the game? It's kind of crucial. If you're a role player like I am, it's very crucial how dice work. Because you're there to role play, not to roll dice. So we'll see what happens. I already looked at this video, so I already know. So I'm not going to spoil it, but you kind of already know what I'm thinking. That I'm even mentioning this. We got this example character here. The fantasy character. So you got the strength, toughness, agility, precision, mind, spirit. These numbers are the number of... Well, we'll find out. I want to say it's the number of dice that you roll. Number of d6s you get to roll. Yeah, so you roll a number of d6, that's weird, d6 equal to the appropriate attribute and count every roll of 4 or higher as a success. So, this reminds me of another game. It's bugging me. There's another game I either downloaded, you know, pay what you want, and I pay $0, and it looks just like this. So strength 5, you roll 5 d6s, and then you count the successes, which would be 4 or higher. And I hate dice pools. I hate them. Absolutely hate them. You're rolling 5 dice. Why? Why on earth are you rolling 5 dice? Anyway. So one of the dice is different, and that is the fate die. I'm guessing there's always a fate die involved. So we got one success, and the fate die was a 1. So what's going to happen here? The roll of 1 on the fate die results in a setback, while a 6 adds a bonus. Okay. Then any dice that roll. Okay. I would say dies, not dice, but that's just me. Any dice that rolls a 6 counts as a success and also explodes. So you're counting the die as one success, and then you get to re-roll that die. And if it scores a success, then add it to the total. So you could get another success, like roll a four or higher. I don't know if does it keep on exploding forever? That'd be so annoying. Oh, by the way, I hate exploding dice more than dice pools. So we got three sixes. That's three successes. Here's a success. So that's, oh, and here's a success, I guess. So that's what, all of it's a success. So that would be what? That would be five successes, and then you get to reroll three of them. Now, there's another one. That would be five plus one, right? Six successes, is that how it works? Oh no, so it does explode forever. Oh my god. Oh no. Oh no. Let's see. Based on the situation, okay. So, if something bad is happening, they call it disadvantage, advantage, that kind of thing. What's this? Grim Jim compared this with the advantages and disadvantages with D&D 5 because he's an idiot. It's a totally different kind of role. But in this one, if you're at a disadvantage, then your success, the successes count only if you roll a 5 or higher. And if you're at an advantage, then your successes count when you roll a 3 or higher on your dice. But still, you're dealing with dice pools, which I hate, and counting the successes, which I hate, and dealing with sixes that explode, which I hate. Now, the reason being I hate that mechanic is, where's the role play? You're too busy rolling dice and then doing the thing and then rolling and what are you doing exactly? What kind of game are you playing? It's not a role play game as far as I can tell. Because once you start rolling those kind of die mechanics, you're playing what I call the RPR system, which is role play removed. And you got the players all hanging around the table. They can't wait. They got their fists of dice. They can't wait to do their die pool rolls. They can't wait for it. That's what they showed up for. That's what they're gaming for. Ay, ay, ay. Anyway. When I see any world, I see generic system, I'm thinking, yes! But in my last, I don't know, in the last decade, I've only found two games I've liked. And that would be Day Tripper and TPS. That's it, those two. They're generic enough, and there's very few die rolls you make. Anyway, I'll let you go. Talk to you later.